using the calculation settings in a pivot table. Once we select our pivot table and we go into the Options tab, we have a section or a group called Calculations. Firstly, let's look at what we have in our pivot table already. We have the sum of the sales, and that was because we dragged the sales column down into the values section. If I go up to the first option in calculations, you'll see that the sum is ticked because that's the one that we're currently using. I could also change this to count, and you can see it's counting the number of sales made by each salesperson in each region. I can find the average sale, I can find the highest, the lowest, or I can multiply. If we, for example, leave it at sum, you'll notice here that it's not bringing in the currency. And the way to do that is when you click on the drop-down arrow and come down here into More Options, we can change the number format into, for example, accounting. And when I press OK, you can see here now we have the currency or the accounting format has been applied. Obviously then, if I change it to count, the accounting format is incorrect. So just to be aware then, you'd go back into More Options, Number Format, change it, for example, back to General or Number, and then press OK, and it will return it back to just being a number. So this is how you can go in to change it from count of sales to sum of sales to average of sales, etc., and also into More Options to change the format. This little option here, Show Values As, is also quite handy. Currently, it's saying that it's not applying any calculation to the sum of the sales. So we could, for example, ask it to apply a calculation that shows us the value as a percentage. And this option here, for example, percentage of grand total, is that it will take the grand total, which is 259,784, and it will make each of these items a percentage of that grand total. So when I click on that, you'll see the grand total is at 100%, and then it's gone and put in a percent for each one of my values. I could also find the percentage of each column total, row total, etc. And as you go down, you'll see you can have the difference from, and you can pick a field for it to find the difference from that field or a percentage difference. And you'll see there's also running totals and ranking things from smallest to largest. Indexing is when it will create an index to show the cells relative to how important it is to the grand total. So these are all worth having a look at. I think probably the one you'll use the most are the top few here, percentage of either grand total, column totals, or row totals. So determine which one of those you want, or go back to no calculation to make it go back to just the ordinary numbers. Finally then, there's an item here called Field Items and Sets. This is if you want to go and create or modify your own calculated fields and items. Currently, however, we have here the sum of sales, which is our calculated field, and we already have our labels at the top and down the side.